A weekly email should be the foundation of your business. That should be the foundation of your personal brand.
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
I think that's where you really build your business, is responding. You know, people know, like, when you send an email, when they send an email to you and you respond really fast, they notice that. They're like, wow, you know, that was quick. Then they send an email and they send another email and you respond right back again. They're like, wow. You know, people want to know what they need to know right now. And if you're the agent that's responding really quickly, you always answer your phone, you're always responding to texts, you're always answering your emails. Now, you got a time block so you can prospect, so you can't always do that. So I think the moral of the story is just to do the best you can do. You know, if it is during that time, see, you have to time block your most important activities. And if you're in the building stage of your business, that most important activity is building your database, which means talking to more people you've never talked to before, and making a great first impression, you know, putting them into your database where now they get their weekly email. A weekly email should be the foundation of your business. That should be the foundation of your personal brand.
We're not doing the weekly emails, none of us.
Big mistake.
Some of us.
1 week, it needs to be on the same day of the week, every week, forever. People need, see, the consistency of it is gonna show them how consistent you are. They're gonna think, wow, this person is hardworking, dependable, knowledgeable, professional. If it's once a month, if you're sending out once a month and other people are sending every week, they're gonna think that you're lazy, not professional, not consistent, not dependable, because they're only getting something every month, whereas other people are sending things weekly. And so,
two questions: generating the content, how do you do that? And then, you know, is that not too much contact for some people?
People get hundreds of spam emails every day. Hundreds every day. If one email a week from their trusted real estate agent is too much, then that's not our client. Understand? The content, okay? You got 4 weeks in a month, right? Week one of the month, listing of the month. Week two of the month, new restaurant of the month. Week three, stats of the month. Week four, an article about something cool going on in the area. Boom. I just came up with that out of thin air. It's not hard, dude. There's new market information every second of the day. There's new listings, new closed sales, new pendings. There's new market information every second. So there's a link on my email that's new listings. It goes back 2 weeks. It's an automatic link that's automatically updated. I don't have to change it every week. Boom. They get the new listings every week. They're looking at the new listings. Closed sales, boom, right? Property search, boom.
Those are your personal listings?
No, listings to the whole area, the entire market, whatever my niche is. See, I'm in Baldwin County, but I'm really primarily focused on Gulf Shores and Orange Beach. So I've got Gulf Shores and Orange Beach new listings on the link.
That's because you've been calling GeoLeads there, right?
It's just where I live. It's just the market that I'm in. Now, if you're in a really big market and you have multiple cities, you have your weekly email, and then you have, you know, say something like pick your area, have a box on the email, and have it say something like pick your area, and then the first link is, you know, that area, next area, whatever you call the different counties or different cities, whatever the top, you know, five cities you work, or even six or seven or 10, whatever, you're gonna have a link to each of those areas, and then that link goes to a page on your website dedicated to that area, where there is the new listings for that area. There is the closed sales. Here is stuff. Here is that. Here's this. And it's a web page on your website that's dedicated to just that area. That way, all those cities can get the same email, but when they go there, they can pick their area if they want more specifics on their specific market stats. I mean, I don't know what all you know, you can put whatever you want on there. You definitely want new listings, some closed sales, stuff like that. You know, subdivisions, maybe you have each subdivision in that area, like the major subdivisions, maybe a link to each one of them that's an automatic link that has all the active listings in that subdivision at any given time, where they can always go to their subdivision and click on it, or subdivision they want to live in and click on it, and it shows all the active listings in that subdivision at the time, and it's all on your website. It's all your contact information. You know, whatever the case may be, they can save the search and get automatic emails when something comes up in that neighborhood, whatever. So you could have the city at the top. You can have a little pair, like a really like two sentence paragraph, you know, below, or, you know, the new listings is updated, you know, daily, you know, closed sales, and then you'll find all the subdivisions in Glendale or whatever the name of it is below. If you ever want to know the active listings or whatever. And so you create those web pages for the different areas, and then boom, the infrastructure's in place. Now you just put those links on your email, and now everybody can get the same email, and it will apply to everyone.